today is not only a fantastic day because we have a heat wave in Paris. It's almost 33 degrees outside. It's also a fantastic day because I'm here with Kalle Brännberg. Kalle, you're a former superstar floorball player, and now you're heading up marketing at Unihoc and Zone. For people who don't know what floorball is, can you give us the elevator pitch?
Well, it's like playing hockey indoor, but instead of playing on ice, you're playing on a rubber floor, and you play with plastic and carbon fiber sticks. Five against five, two goalies, and it's a big sport in Sweden, especially in Sweden, in the northern parts of Europe, and it's growing bigger and bigger for every day, so it's interesting.
And when you say a big sport, it's not that it's growing. There are actually hundreds and thousands of licensed players in Sweden, so it's like almost the biggest sport, depending on how you count it now.
Yeah, besides soccer or football, it's the biggest sport in Sweden, and it's the biggest indoor sport overall. So it's a big sport here. Yeah,
cool. But we're not here to talk about floorball. We're here to talk about why is digital important for you? How is digital impacting an industry such as floorball?
Well, I think first of all, floorball is a pretty young sport. So most of our customers are pretty young right now. It's a young sport. It's trendy. It's pretty innovative still in the business. So because of our customers and clients are in that pretty young age, between like 10 to 15 years, it's really important to be on the social medias for us. The more marketing we can do in those platforms with great content connected to our products, I think we'll be quite a big winners, because that's the key straight into our focus group regarding clients.
So your demographics are everything from 10-year-old kids up to 15, and then obviously everyone.
We sell sticks to even older guys and girls, but if you should see like the core in our business and the clients that we reach out to the most, it's those guys that hang out on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter every day. So I think those channels are the most important marketing channels that we have right now, straight into our platform.
So which are the most important digital platforms for your brands? Is it Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook?
Well, for us right now, it's Instagram, easily. That's where we put the most focus from our side, and that's also where we get the most or the best impact back. It's a lot of print screens, a lot of shares, a lot of comments, a lot of likes as well, and right now it's free. So I think as well, Instagram is really, really big here in Sweden, in the northern parts of Europe, and I think therefore it's our best channel right now to reach out to the customers.
And obviously, we're very happy that you use the CRM cloud to monitor and analyze all of this data. But when you look at the Instagram data, what kind of stuff is it that the kids are sharing related to not only Unihoc, but floorball as such?
Well, right now we see a trend that a lot of guys and girls would like to share their own move. We've done it in a campaign 2 years ago where we started something called the My Move, where we videotape the stars of Unihoc, one of our brands, and we put them on YouTube, and they like created their own super moves. And after that, we've seen like a trend in the social medias where other people try to share their own move. So this summer, we are shooting the third like campaign of the My Move, which will be more focused on Instagram, a bit more quick compared to before where we focused on YouTube. So that's one of the trends that we see on Instagram that is really, really popular. The other thing is that more and more people get used to share their own product. And especially on Zone, for example, we've added a small tab on our sticks where we...
Like, Zone, which is your other floorball brand.
Exactly, yeah. And we've added a small sticker or something in the artwork that is like telling the kids that are buying our sticks to show us their own product, how it's looked like, and their own blade or grip band and so on. So It's interesting to see on the hashtags what people are buying, what people are sharing, and what people are showing their other friends. So showing the product and creating their own moves is pretty big right now.
So to sum it up, your strategy is very much about energizing the player or the end consumer to share stuff related to your brand. Either you teach them, this is how we can make a my move, a cool dribble or a feint, or this is how you can hook your stick, and you sort of give them the tools to create branded content on social media channels. Is that correctly understood?
I think that's correct. And the more we do to inspire them to play floorball, to create their own moves and so on, I think it's better for us, for our brands, and also for the sport of floorball. So we try to inspire them as well to take some cool pictures of their sticks, to create their own moves and so on, to make the sport grow, and to make our brands grow together with them. And I think that's important.
Do you see any difference in the different regions? Because you sell floorball sticks not only to Sweden. Is Sweden the most active market when it comes to talking about floorball brands, or is there any new market that is popping up?
Well, I think Czech Republic is pretty good at speaking about their own products, because they seem like they're pretty, you know, proud of showing their own products. But especially Sweden is big, but it's also the biggest country and market for us. So of course there's more mentions in Sweden compared to Czech Republic. But if you divide it into the amount of players that they have on every country, I think Czech Republic might be the most high speaking business right now in the floral industry.
What are the top three things you're looking at when you're monitoring social media? What are the three metrics that you can't live without in the CRM cloud?
Well, that's a tricky question because we are it's not only me here at Renew that is working with the CRM cloud. But the thing that is most important for me, as because I'm both a marketer and also a product developer or designer, and for me it's really, really important to see how the business is going right now, because we see trends through a CRM cloud, and we see if people are satisfied with stuff, we see if people are disappointed at stuff we do, and then we also see what other brands are doing right now. So it gives us a complete look of the business to see, okay, what is going good, what is selling good, what has a high acceptance out there. And I think that's most important for me as both a marketer and a product developer, I'd say.
You mentioned innovation in the start of our conversation. How do you see product innovation going forward in the floorball industry?
Well, I think we've had a large variety of products coming out to the market the last 5 or 10 years, and now it's slowly going back towards golf or hockey. That it's I think the market is pretty used to getting new products every day, and now it's important for us, because sometimes you come to a level where it's not possible to create new stuff all over again. And I think you see that on football or on hockey or golf as well. But now we feel that we need to, instead of just creating the product, we need to create a story. We need to create a story together with other brands, for example, to create co-producting. I think that's important, because we have come to a level now where the business is so developed. So we need to think in other directions, just not only think about the product, but we need to think about the product. We need to tell a story together with our brand, our history, and deliver something more, just not only the product, but a complete story. I think that's the future for football business.
Very well said, Kalle. And how's your own floorball career doing now?
Pretty bad. I'll try to play some games this year with a low division team here in Sweden. Hopefully I can help some other team, maybe like Paris, for some games throughout the year, but we'll see. But you know,
you're obviously very welcome to IFK Paris. you know that. Listen, it's been a pleasure having you on the show and sharing some insights about how Unihoc is using the SCRM cloud. So thank you very much for that, Kalle.
No worries. Talk to you soon.
Ciao. Bye.
Bye.